Welcome back. Well, yes, indeed. That's where we continue with Honorable Kingsley Cuckoo joining us today. He is the special advisor to the president on Niger Delta affairs and also the president of the presidential, not chair, of the presidential amnesty committee.
He just made me president.
Who knows? Thank you for coming on this morning, by the way.
Thank you.
But most part of last week, National Assembly, I think some statements credited to the Niger State Governor, were all talking about what you were alleged to have said, and most of them also did say that they expected, in fact, some of them directed that the IG of Police should invite you. In fact, Mr. Fallon, I think in some countries, you would have been arrested and asked certain questions about what you said. What did you actually say?
I'm sure, I want to thank you. I'm sure you would have asked Ebonfemi quite well if he was even referring to me. I'm sure he wasn't doing that to me. He should be talking about some other people.
What about the House of Representatives?
Not me. The House was very specific. You see, we have a culture of reportage, of hyping what has been said. A motion was moved by a member of the House of Reps that these statements were alleged to have been made. The first step would have been to even find out exactly what has been said. But because they also didn't, I was a member of the House, because the House, as exalted as it is, wouldn't want a situation where misinformation will lead to some resolution. The House did pass a resolution on the motion that the IG should probe the alleged statement that one Honorable Kingsley Cuckoo would have made in the United States, as alleged. Of course, as a matter of fact, I have just been misconstrued. I have been misinterpreted, maybe consciously.
Let me read out what was written out there so that
yes,
you can correct
do.
It for
yeah,
us.
Please
because
do.
It was published and
please
they
do.
Say that you were quoted to have said there will be dire consequences in the Niger Delta should Goodluck Jonathan fail to secure a fresh term in 2015. And this, they say, was in Washington, D.C., while you were speaking with officials of the U.S. State Department, led by Deputy Assistant Secretary of State Bureau of African Affairs.
Well, I didn't say that in the first place. Let me clarify this very clearly, that I did not in any way, I could not have even said that. I'm a Democrat. I was a member of Parliament. I have always been in public service for too long a time. And I know about this president being a fountain of democracy. He benefited even beyond states that the PDP didn't hold sway, like the Southwest, which is basically an ACN place, but during the presidential election in 2011, massively over 90% of the ACN members and those who are not members of ACN in the Southwest voted for this president. So Democrats like us will not come up anywhere, not to talk of a place like the United States, to say that except President Goodluck Ebele-Jonathan is re-elected in 2015, there will be chaos, there will be dire consequences. No, I didn't say
What I exactly said
was this. It's just been interpreted by those who have the comfort to say interpret it because they are playing opposition politics. They are against anything good that somebody says about the president. I did state in the United States, and I have no apology to this, that President Goodluck Ebele-Jonathan has been able to secure and stabilize the Niger Delta. That is not perfect. It cannot be perfect. That is not perfect anywhere. That even now there are grieved people in the Niger Delta. There are people in the Niger Delta who still believe that the cause of amnesty should not be a solution to the problems and agitation of the region. These people are still on with the agitation, but we keep managing it. The president manages it even at the presidential level. And as his advisor on Niger Delta, he has directed me so well. Nothing inimical must happen in the region. And I must collaborate with my office must collaborate with the security agencies in the region that are doing so well. In the United States, what I basically said had to do with collaboration between the United States and the federal government in terms of securing and stabilizing the amnesty program and the Niger Delta. That the Niger Delta is so important, is vital, that what is happening in the northeast of the country must not be a way of distracting attention from the stability of the region. That it is when the Niger Delta is stable, that the economic state will be to an extent very stable, and government will have the wherewithal to deal with the security challenges we have in the country. Where we distract our attention from stability in the Niger Delta and move every attention to the northeast, where Boko Haram insurgency is on, and the Niger Delta boys, for instance, God forbid, we will not have the wherewithal financially to deal with governance and also deal with the security challenges we have all over the country.
In other words, you're saying you did not tie 2015
for any reason. It's not possible.
You did not mention 2015.
2015 was not even
election.
Discussed in the United States. But I did state that the president has done so well, because I am one of the few Nigerians who believe very strongly that this president has done so well, though well underreported, underpublicized by the Nigerian media. Consciously and unconsciously, some people in opposition who have a comfort to continue to make him appear not doing well, but the common Nigerians who are the mass do believe that this president has done so well. And since somebody has done well, he deserves a second term, if he so desires to have this second term and he makes himself available to Nigerians. It's Nigerians who are going to debate this and agree to who is going to be their president come 2015.
So
I didn't say that.
So at no point did the word dire consequences.
Dire consequences before United States State Department. I am too enlightened, too educated. I am a Democrat. I wouldn't say that kind of thing.
I think it's getting really, really out of hand.
Because I did not even present a paper.
The way we get to see statements and comments in the news space. First, it was a statement on Sunday linking the Minister of Information to the Nasarawa crisis, and he had to come up to say, I never said that. Until this moment, that newspaper hasn't even said where and how they got their story.
It's funny.
You're being quoted to have said something in faraway United States, and here you are, say you never used such words, and never said that.
Who was there in the United States with me?
That is a question I wanted to ask you. Who was there with you who got that story out?
Who was there with me? Nobody. No Nigerian media person was there in the United States with me. I addressed the United States Council for Africa. I addressed the Woodrow Wilson Center. I addressed the United States Institute of Peace.
How does it feel? How does it feel?
And it was all about cementing and stabilizing the amnesty program for this country.
How does it feel when stories like this come out and you say, well, these are business allegations which you never said? Because now I'm trying to link it up all through the process from Sunday, the Minister for Information, you and so many other names, and everyone has come out to say, show me any evidence to show that I actually said this. Until this moment, we haven't seen any.
You know what that points to you? It points to you that there has been a problem. And this problem has to do with the media. A great percentage of the Nigerian media has made up its mind, either consciously or unconsciously, to be used by opposition elements or by elements who do not want anything good to be associated with the president. Let me tell you, with this administration, this is a president that has made it possible for quite within a period of 30 years for trains to move from Lagos to Kano. And this is going to replicate itself to Port Harcourt, to Enugu, to all parts of this country. This is a president, for the first time in the history of this country, who has allowed opposition to grow. Opposition has grown under President Goodluck Ebele Jonathan than anybody who has claimed as a leader of this country to be a Democrat. Instead of that to be a plus to him, people use the growth of opposition, which is a basic ingredient of democracy, they use it against him, that he's weak, he's clueless, and when he comes out to say, like former leaders, that opposition must not strive, people will call him a despot. So you see a situation where the media must be forthright in performing their professional duty.
Have you since challenged the media that published what you said, what they said you said? Have you gone to them saying, listen,
Separately, I held a press conference in my office last week, and the media was there, and the media did report that I did not say so. But having said that, you still see a lot of people, because it's at their own political comfort. I don't blame anybody. Here, opposition has thrived under this president. And opposition is there to say that, look, this is a Kingsley Kuku who is saying that the president has done well in the area of securing the Niger Delta, he's done well about the railways, he's done well about the airports. You can't controvert this fact that he's done well about agricultural ministry, he's done well about a lot of places, and that he deserves, if it's so. For instance, about electricity. People keep saying that this president has not done well. In electricity, we inherited nothing up to 2,000 megawatts. But this country today experiences nothing less than 4,000 megawatts. It will be better in December.
Now, there's There's usually.
So why are we not reporting all this?
There's this saying that says there's no smoke without fire. Are you saying that you've not at any point in time, whether in the U.S. or maybe even here in Nigeria, not said anything that will cause this kind of stories to be
Let me tell you how it works in politics. I do understand if you don't. I am in public service. I've been a politician. Politicians in Nigeria, the moment they get elected or the moment they do not get elected, 2 years into a subsisting tenure, they begin to prepare for what is not possible maybe in the sight of God in 2015. People at their political comfort zone have determined the way they want to run their opposition politics. That is exactly what they are doing. Let us look at those areas where this president is doing well. Who are the principals handling these programs? And we begin to eat at them and make them unpopular, make the president weak. It does not work. It is not going to be to the benefit of Nigeria as a country for those of us who are managing the security situation, managing the peace process in the Niger Delta, to be attacked uncalled for. It is not going to be a reasonable thing for this country.
Is it possible that this story got out through the State Department? Because if you say there was no Nigerian media there present in that meeting with the State Department in D.C., isn't it possible that perhaps...
The United States Department don't speak to people like that. I have been a product of public service for quite over 15 years. And if I have told you this, that I did say this president has done well in these areas based on programs, if he so decides. And you know the president has told everybody, look, don't drag me into 2015.